This is René voor Network Lessons. In this video, I'll show you how to configure a certificate authority on a Ubuntu server using OpenSSL. So before we start messing around with OpenSSL, there's a couple of things you should do. One of them is you should verify that your clock is synced, your date, your time zone, and it's also a good idea to set the host name and fully qualified domain name. So let's start with NTP. You can see that the date here, date, time zone. This is correct for me, but it is a good idea to install NTP client. So let's do sudo apt-get install NTP. And we'll do a quick verification to see if our time will be synchronized or not. So once you have installed NTP, you can do NTP q-p. And here you can see all the different NTP servers that this server will use to synchronize itself. So that's something you should do. And the other thing is checking the hostname. So if you do hostname or hostname-f, you can see that the hostname is CA. But I'd like to set the fully qualified domain name. So go to your hosts file, and then over here we'll put the fully qualified domain name in front of the hostname. So this server is going to be called ca.networklessons.local. Save the file, and here you can see the hostname and fqdn. Alright, so now we can start working on OpenSSL. And I'd like to switch to root for this. And first, we'll have to create a couple of folders. I'm going to store everything in the root/ca folder. And then in this folder, we'll have to create a couple of new folders. One is called new search, CRL, private, and we got requests. So these are the folders that we need, and we're going to use some of them in this video. We also need a file called index.txt. It has to be empty, so I'm going to use the touch command to create it. So you can see it has been created, 0 bytes. And we also need a file which stores the serial number that we're going to use for our certificates. So I'm going to do something like this. So I need to have a file called serial, and this will contain the first serial number that will be used for certificates. And in my case, I'm going to use 1234 as the first serial number. Okay, so these are all the files and folders that we need. What we can do now is we have to create a private key, and then we'll have to create a root certificate. So let's start with the private key. Generate RSA. I'm going to use AES 256 bits. And I'm going to store the private key in the private folder. And I'm going to use 4096 bits. Okay, so it has been created. You need to set a passphrase. If this is for a production network, then make sure you use a complex passphrase here. For this lab, I'm going to use something simple. Okay, so now we have the private key, and we can use this as the input for our root certificate. So let's create that root certificate. X509 format. The key, that'll be the private key, cakey.pem. And I'm going to store the root certificate as cacert.pem. And I want it to be valid for 10 years. Enter the passphrase we just created. And then we have to fill in some of the fields here. So country name, NL, the province or state. This is the province I live in. The city, organization, section, going to skip this, And this is the FQDN. So let's fill in the FQDN of our server. Email address. And that's it. Okay. So now we have a root certificate. You can see it over here, cacert.pem. If you do a cat, then you can see the actual certificate here. Okay, so far so good. So now we have a working certificate authority. But there's a couple of things we should do. First of all, you should change the permissions. So right now you can see the permissions over here for these files and folders. And it's probably a better idea to restrict this to our root user. So if you do something like this, chmod 600, then only root can read and write these files and folders. So this will keep any other users out of these folders. The other thing we need to do is make some changes to the OpenSSL config file. So let's open this file. And then we'll have to scroll down a bit to this section over here, CA default. The folder by default is called demo CA. So let's change it to root/CA. So that's one thing I have to change. And all the other stuff I can just leave it. This is something you might want to change. Default days is 1 year. So if you're going to create a certificate, it will be valid for 1 year. But you can increase it if you want. The other thing you might want to look at is this over here, policy. So the default policy is called policy match. And you can see that country, state or province, and the organization, these are all required fields. They have to match on the certificates. On a production network, that might be wise to keep. But for this lab, I'm going to set everything to optional. There we go. And that's basically it. So all the other stuff, I'm going to just leave it. So write and quit file. And that's all that we have. So right now we have a working certificate authority. So it's ready to start signing certificates. So normally, let's say that you have some web server. Then on this web server, you could create a certificate signing request. And then our server here can sign the request and create a certificate. But what we can also do is create the request on this server and then sign it ourselves. So that's something we can do, and I'm going to show you how to do this so that you can test your certificate server. So what we'll do is I'll go to the requests folder and I'm going to create a request for some server. So let's say that we have a web server that should have a certificate. So this folder is empty, but what I'm going to do is I'll create a private key for my fake web server. So I'm going to use AES 256 bits and the private key should be 2048 bits. You need to enter a passphrase for it. So let's do that. And now we can create the certificate request. So it's a new request. I'm going to use the web server private key. And the request itself should be saved as webserver.csr. Enter the passphrase. And now we have to enter all of these fields. So let's do it. Let's call it webserver.networklessons.local. And it might be wise to set a password, but for this example, I'm not going to do so. There we go. So I got these two files now. The private key. You can see it here. Private key. And the CSR file, which is the request. So this is the request that we created. And now I'm going to sign this request. So OpenSSL, we use the CA. The input will be the request. And the output will be a new file. Let's call this file webserver.crt. So that will be the certificate. Enter the passphrase. And now it asks us if we want to sign it. So let's say yes. Commit. Yes. There we go. So now we created this new certificate. And you can see it over here. So webserver.crt. You can see the complete certificate over here. All right. So what we can do is we can move the certificate to the certificate folder. And so I copied it so I can remove it here. And let's also move the private key. Let's copy it to the private folder. There we go. So let's take a look at the search folder here. Here we got our web server certificate. All right, so this is looking good. Huh? So we created a certificate authority. We created a root certificate. Then we created a request for a web server. And we also signed the certificate. So we are done here, but it might be nice to take a look at these certificates in Windows. So let me show you what these certificates really look like. So what I'll do is I'll copy these files to another folder. So the web server certificate, and I'm going to copy the CA certificate. And I'm copying them to this folder because this is a folder I can access through SCP so that I can copy them from this server to my Windows desktop. What I'm also going to do is rename this file, the PEM file, to CRT. Because Windows doesn't like PEM files and it does like CRT files. So we got the root certificate and the web server certificate. And I need to change the permissions. So this is basically the lazy way of doing it. But this will allow me to copy them. Let me check the IP address. 100.25. So let's copy these files. From the server to my desktop. All right, so I got these two files. Let me show you them. So we got the CA certificate and the web server certificate. So when we look at the root certificate, Windows is telling me that it's not trusting it, which makes sense because this is a self-signed certificate. You can see it's valid for 10 years. So let's go ahead and install it. Install it for this user. And I need to install this root certificate in the Trusted Root Certification Authorities. Okay. Next. Finish. We get a big security warning. That's okay. And it's successful. So my Windows computer is now trusting any certificate that has been signed by the root certificate. So if I open it again, you can see that it's no longer showing a warning. It is trusting this root certificate. So when we look at the web server certificate, you can see that this web is issued to the web server. It's valid for 1 year. And you can see that I'm not seeing any errors here. So Windows is trusting this certificate. And if you look at the certification path, You can see the web server certificate, which has been signed by ca.networklessons.local. So if you would install this web server certificate on a web server and then browse any website on that web server, then my computer will trust the web server because it is trusting the root CA. So that's basically it. So you have now seen how to create a certificate authority on Ubuntu using OpenSSL. You have also seen how you can create requests, sign your certificates, and how you can install the root certificate on your Windows computer. So I hope this has been useful, and you can use these certificates for servers, routers, firewalls, or any other devices that require a certificate. Anyway, thanks for watching, and till next time.